Escape to action and excitement at the premier Chicagoland spot for live poker. Hit the WSOP branded tables for low and high stakes cash games, along with great tournament structures in our newly opened room where the poker tables are smoking hot. Come out and play at Harris Joliet Casino and Hotel. Must be 21 or older to gamble. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER.
All right, guys, I've got a great way for us to help out Shady Oaks Camp. Point your browser to shadyoakscamp.org today and make a donation. For every dollar you contribute, you get one raffle ticket to winning your own personalized copy of Jerry Yang's new book, All In, From Refugee Camp to Poker Champ. And what's even better is you'll have the opportunity to receive your copy on our program. Remember, the more you donate, the more chances you get to win.
And now, a poker tip from Nick Brancato.
When you raise preflop, don't get married to your hand. If someone re-raises you, calling can be a huge mistake. If you call, it's easy to end up playing a large pot with a marginal hand against an opponent who's shown great strength preflop. The problem's compounded even further if you're playing out of position. When you're facing a re-raise, it's often better to either put in a third raise or fold.
A great tip from poker professional Nick Brancato. Welcome back to the Windy City Poker Championship. As we continue play, blinds are now 500, 1,000 with a 100 ante. There are 32 players left in this Windy City Poker Championship. Let's get back to the action. Jack right. Deuce, no good.
No good. No one's finding anything to play. Wait a minute. Steven and his quick raise. Quick draw McGraw, we're going to call him. Got King 10 off.
Lightning fast raise to 2,000.
Again, I just don't like the 2,000 raise.
It's too small if you're trying to steal. It's fine if you're trying to induce a call. I don't think he wants any action with King 10, though. Except maybe from Kirk.
You know, Kirk's got the button. He's been bluffing a lot. And I think maybe he's thinking that Steven knows that, so that he can't always bluff. So maybe he thinks that a raise here could take it down. He's on the button, so he has position.
Exactly what he does. Makes it 4,700 to go.
Raise and a re-raise. Ace 4, no good. Deuce 5.
Even worse.
Even worse. As quickly as he raised, Steven now mucks.
Nice. Thief.
You know, I have a feeling that Kirk is somehow related to Jamie Gold. They both just played a bluff.
Ace queen.
Look at this. There he goes. Now he's showing the bluff again. He's going to get caught.
Okay. I can use some cards now.
Just pretend you're Kirk.
Put some I don't have any there. Sunglasses. I can't, like, put on my serious face.
Sign of a really good dealer, always making sure that he pulls in the antes before he deals.
An even better dealer says, ante up!
Your poker magazine. Okay, the blinds are posted. Here we go. Jeff's got five tray of clubs. Oh, and he mucks it under the gun. Oh my, I would have raised there.
It's amazing how every hand has a five tray.
Now we got a couple of folds over to Vic in the hijack seat. A suited ace 5, he makes just a call there. I don't know if I like that play, Scott.
Now, when you're in the hijack and you're first come in with a hand like that, I want to raise. Put some pressure on those blinds.
Speaking of that, small blind now is King Jack of Hearts. Heather looks like she wants to raise, and she does. She makes it 4,000. That's a nice raise.
Fairly certain she sensed some weakness in Vic.
There goes two of Vic's spades. Nice. Person is lifts. That's usually a sign of weakness. This is the problem with playing ace 5 and not playing it for a raise. You really don't know where you are in this hand. Does he really want to commit 3,000 more chips to see a flop?
Does put a lot of thought into this. And makes the call.
Headed to the flop. Eight of hearts, queen of spades, five of hearts. A big flop for Heather.
Oh, so okay. Big she lost her chips. There they are.
She's got a flush draw and one over.
Seven.
She makes a bet of 7,000. That's a nice bet.
Plus, she had control of the hand. It always helps.
You can tell already Vic doesn't like that bet. I don't know. He's got a pair, Scott. He's in position. What do you think? Should he make the call here?
The problem is he really gave up control of his hand pre-flop, so we don't really know what Heather has. It's tough to play back here at this point.
But it looks like, yep, he's going to let it go. The beauty of power poker, displayed wonderfully by Heather, takes down a nice pot there. As you may have noticed, we have some new players at the table. Melissa VanDyke replaces Romel Reid in the 5 seat. She advanced out of flight 1F and took advantage of their re-entry option. She sits here with 42,000 chips.
One of the great features of this tournament. That there is Ray Boom Boom Mancini in seat 7. He replaces Vic Magsino.
He has almost 68,000 in chips. Kirk calls with King 3. Again, I can't figure out Kirk. Maybe that's his style. Another pocket pair for Leonid. Either this is incredibly coincidental or some careful editing.
All he gets are pocket pairs.
Makes a raise to 2,400. Again, a small raise. I just don't understand it.
Less than 3x with a medium pocket pair. Gotta put some more pressure on these folks.
Especially Heather. She's got a big stack here now. She can try to set mine with her pocket threes. One ace. Two aces for Jeff. Wow. Let's see how he plays a big hand.
That's the most aces you can start with pre-flop.
I raise.
Now the question is, we have a raise and a call and a limper too, plus some dead money. How much are you going to make it here? That's the thing.
I'd like to get down to heads up.
He's got a lot of yellow chips.
Plays with his chips a lot. That might come back to hurt him.
There you go, 10,000. That's about 4 times the original raise. I don't know, I might have made it more there, I think, but we'll see how it goes. You know Kirk's getting out of the way. Just looking for TV time on his own show. Now, Leonid has a dilemma here.
A tough spot here with pocket tens.
You know, after his raise, he only has about 32,000 chips. Really, it seems to me it's either a shove or fold situation. It's hard to justify just calling here, I think. He thinks better of it. Maybe he read something on Jeff there.
How much?
7,000.
Heather, though, which started the hand with about 100,000 in chips, can make this call a little more easily, though it's still a little surprising to me.
Yeah, I don't know if I still like the call, regardless how deep she is, but we'll see. We'll see what happens.
She is in position, so he's just playing two big cards.
Wow, look at that flop. Queen, Jack, 10. This is not the type of flop you want to see if you're Jeff with pocket aces. And, of course, Leonid is just sick. He would have flopped bottom set. Would have been good.
Wow. Very tough board for pocket aces here, but you have to put in some kind of bet. Or two.
Have you noticed that he plays with his chips a lot when he's nervous?
Yes.
Very fast. The speed of the...
Very nervous.
That's right.
Kind of looked like string bet to me, just saying.
I dropped it on my way out. I didn't string bet it.
All right, after a little discussion, the aces are going to hold up. It's going to take down a nice pot, almost 40,000 chips.
Windy City Poker Championship returns after the commercial break. Stay tuned.
We want to thank you, Chicagoland, for over 50 years of loyalty.
And we'd love to add you to our family of over 200,000 satisfied customers. If you're in the market for a great quality garage, take a look at this.
Call Danley's and we'll build your new garage with free wreck and haul of your old garage. Or take $1,500 off a new garage. Quality work, quality service. That's Danley's Garage World.
Danley's 773.